We have Dr. Luis Tamadas. For those of you who do not know him, he is the Director of Medical Affairs for the Richard M. DeVos family and the renowned cardiothoracic surgeon. Well, we are going to begin by discussing the donor awareness movement and how this has evolved over the years. And Dr. Tamadas, I'm going to begin with you. Will you please explain for us Rich DeVos's proposal to increase organ donations through financial incentives?
We are attached on that. Can you hear me well? Well, we are blessed to be in a city who is the second largest organ donor per population in the country and the largest organ donor in the state of Michigan for the last 26 years. This is a blessing and it's a tribute to all of you and the conscience of this city about the social responsibility. I worked for Rich DeVos, who almost 18 years ago got a heart transplant. As soon as he came out of the operation, he said, Luis, we have to do something to get more organs. He said, I waited 5 months and I thought I was going to die before the heart of life. And we have been working since then. One of the things that struck us from the beginning is we are going in the wrong way. We just ask somebody who has lost or has been told that he has lost a loved one that has died brain-wise with perfect functioning heart, kidney, lungs, etc. And then we ask, when they haven't had the chance to absorb that tragedy, to donate the organ. And I think it's even cruel to do that. But we have to do it because they know the alternative. And what Rich thought is, well, we look for a system in which the real owner of the organ decides what is going to be done with his organ after he dies, he or she dies. And one of the ways to do it was to incentivize the people, offering them, when they sign the driver's license or income tax form, is benefit and insurance, life insurance for $20,000 if they become the donor. Who pays for that? The same people that are paying for 60% of the donors that are kidney. That costs about $400,000 a year, $20,000 is a bargain. And it cannot be done because there is a federal law, not that an OPA, that says that you cannot do and offer any size of reward or monetary reward. But it has to be changed. Because there is no moral argument, or there is no argument about the philanthropy of somebody that says, well, if I die and my organ can be keep somebody alive. What wants more philanthropy than that? That it is not even we know where this organ is going to go. And then another of the arguments was about the exploitation of the poor. Just think, life insurance for $20,000 costs $1.50 a month. Are you exploiting the poor individual that cannot afford that? Or you are entitling them, or if not him, the beneficiaries that have lost the breadwinner, that possibly with $20,000 can be several months until the situation changes. Then, again, it's a long fight. Unfortunately, the National Kidney Foundation is one of the oppositions to that. But I have very good friends that we have discussed this argument all over the country, and again, we respect that, but eventually it will continue. There are many articles that are coming, there are books that are being written, And eventually, we will, accept the way we treat the organization.
Very good, thank you.